Bill Belichick had a second interview with the Atlanta Falcons this past week, but otherwise, the 71-year-old six-time Super Bowl winner, put some respect on his name, has had no other reported interviews. Here's Adam Schefter on the latest.
The Falcons have this open search. Like, there's a lot of people. And maybe in the end it comes up on Bill, but maybe it doesn't. We don't know how it's going to work out. But so far, like, that's the only team that I can tell that has engaged in heavy conversation. That's crazy to me, but that's the reality.
All right. I've been waiting to tackle this one. Stephen A., are you surprised that Bill Belichick, who many have called the greatest coach of all time, there isn't more interest in him, just the Atlanta Falcons, who aren't contenders by any means?
Sadly, no, I am not surprised. For the record, I think it's important that everybody here knows. I believe that the Dallas Cowboys, I'm not advocating swagoo that Mike McCarthy should have been fired. I think there's a difference between you being fired and a team saying, look, we appreciate you, but that's a six-time champion over there. We can't pass up this opportunity. You see the difference? I'm saying that you don't boot Mike McCarthy out the door because he lost a playoff game to the Green Bay Packers when he had back-to-back-to-back 12-win seasons. But you do boot him out the door to get a six-time champion when you're an 81-year owner and you're supposedly starving for a championship. And clearly, that was what I thought in regards to that. But nevertheless, looking at that and looking at the Philadelphia situation, which I also thought should have given it consideration, I still can sit here and tell you that I'm not surprised, and here's why. It's something that I've said for weeks, months actually, and I'll say it again. Bill Belichick is responsible in a lot of people's eyes for Tom Brady walking out the door in New England. So from that moment forward, you are the guy that pushed out the golden boy. If Tom Brady, doggy, had said, it's time for me to hang it up. I really appreciate everybody. I love y'all, blah, blah, blah. Beautiful press conference. Hug one another, sing kumbaya. Bill Belichick would still be in New England. They would still revere him. And we would just have to go through a process where we have to rebuild. But because he nudged Tom Brady out the door, because Tom Brady wanted him to kiss the ring, per se, as they say, and that didn't happen. Robert Kraft had to go along with that after years of supporting Tom Brady. Once that happened, it was on Bill Belichick. When Tom Brady won the Super Bowl championship in Tampa, what did Robert Kraft reportedly say? That man, as in Bill Belichick, told me that this man couldn't play anymore. And here he is winning a damn Super Bowl championship. And from that point forward, Tom Brady wins a championship. New England makes the playoff one time in 4 years, gets shellacked by Buffalo by about 40-plus. They can't find an offense. They can't build talent. They can't do anything. And so now if you're Atlanta, you're Philly, you're Dallas, you're anybody else, it's two things that you're saying. Number one, there's no way in hell we want him to run the show. We want him to coach, but we don't want him to run the show. But secondly, and more importantly, even if he were to coach, isn't this the same dude that hired Matt Patricia and Joe Judge as offensive coordinators and has derailed the career of Mac Jones, who was once an all-pro in his rookie year and has gone from that to virtual obscurity because he's played like hot garbage? That was under Bill Belichick. And because of that, combined with his resume, I can see teams saying, we know we don't want him to run the show, but he's Bill Belichick. And in Atlanta, I got a CEO, what's his name again? McKay, right? Okay. I don't know if Bill Belichick's going to want to listen to him or anybody else. And I think that's where your problem lies. I'm not surprised.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think when you bring Belichick in, he is your franchise, and I think owners are a little scared of that. And I think an owner would say, okay, they call Kraft. Bob, let me. What's your thoughts about Belichick? Hey, he's a great coach, but it's his team. You're the owner. You're almost like a passenger. So I think that scares people off. But I have to be surprised. I mean, he's not as good as Lombardi, in my opinion, but he's the greatest, second greatest coach of all time. I thought maybe Dallas would make a move after their loss. I thought maybe Sirianni would make a move after they lost. If Buffalo didn't make the playoffs, maybe they would have made a move as far as McDermott is concerned. He won't go now. He's done a good job there, kept the team together. I thought maybe the Chargers, but then you had Harbaugh become available. Mm-hmm. So I think that hurt him a little bit with Harbaugh's availability. So I think part of it's circumstances. Jones kept McCarthy, Sirianni, Harbaugh available. But I am surprised. I think in the big picture, if you're an owner in the NFL and you got a guy here who's won 6 Super Bowls and been in 9 of them, and he's a tremendous coach who still wants to do it, and you're an owner and you haven't won, hold on now, we haven't won yet. And I got this guy
in coaching standpoint for the last 3 to 4 years. When we start talking, the defense has been solid, and obviously that's his position of focus. But I could see Mad Dog that scaring teams about how Bill Belichick will come into an organization and what his focus and view would be from a building standpoint, because he's been bad, man. We talked about the draft picks that haven't worked out. They've been solid. We talked about the decline of Mac Jones, but more importantly, Stephen, they pointed out the hiring of Matt Patricia and Joe Judge. And then you bring in Bill O'Brien as an offense coordinator and you don't have success as well. So maybe the tread to these organizations is not what we think of it, Mad Dog, to be. But I'm with you. I have to be surprised when a coach has won 6 Super Bowls and been the 9, and he is not a hot commodity on the market. Initially, I thought every vacancy, it would be about Bill Belichick, and then we'll get to the other guys. Harbaugh was a little fly in the ointment because of the success that he's had. But it's surprising. But when Stephen A. made that argument, and it's something that I've legitimately thought about, is has the game passed Bill Belichick by how you have to approach roster building, how you have to be open to having more voices in the organization, how you may have to be open to the analytical side of football. All of those things, I think, come into play when you start thinking about bringing them in, and maybe that's the hindrance, Mad Dog. I can be surprised, but I can also see that other side of why Bill Belichick is not thought of like that.
Doggy, Swagoo, let me use what has transpired in recent memory in the sport of basketball to crystallize this point. We have coaches, like, for example, I'm telling you right now, Larry Brown has forgotten more basketball than most coaches know, okay? And there's a plethora of others who could argue the same. But what happened is that the new guard comes in. And while the new guard has no choice but to respect what you have done, they want their own thing. And if you're accomplished and you're addicted to the way that you do things, you're going to compromise their influence and their power. And they're not going to be receptive to doing that unless they have a choice, which means that if you're a member of the old guard, what you have to do is find a way to get in their head, you're good. You don't mind adapting. New times are new times. That old person that you saw, that's not me anymore. I make that adjustment, et cetera, et cetera. Can you see Bill Belichick doing that? He turned 72 in April, by the way. Can you see him doing that?
It's tough to
hear. Can you really see him doing that? Especially if you're an organization that hasn't won. If you Jerry Jones and the Dallas Cowboys, while I was winning 6 titles and going to 9 championships, you couldn't even get to an NFC championship game. If you the Atlanta Falcons, don't get me started. The only time we knew you had a pulse was a few years ago when Kyle Shanahan was your coordinator, Quinn was your head coach, and you blew a 28-3 lead. And the only other time than that was when you went to the Super Bowl in the 90s. You understand? But a couple of people got themselves in trouble, and that became the headline instead of the damn game itself. And so when you look at all of that, you're going to tell Bill Belichick what to do? You're not. And they know it. And they're like, why even try? I'm not saying I think Atlanta, they should hire him. They need him. But, I'm not surprised that he's having these kind of problems.
Last word here, Marcus.
Stephen A., let me say this and to Doggy as well, because you bring up a great point about Bill Belichick and maybe he's too stubborn to change. The new guard is what's winning. And when we think about just this playoff in particular, we give Andy Reid so much credence. And remember, we had the conversation about, can Andy Reid win the big one? Now, Patrick Mahomes has a lot to do with that. But Andy Reid decided to become very innovative offensively. He ushered in some of this new ideology of coaching.
Yeah, but he said, but he said it was because of Patrick Mahomes. He said Patrick Mahomes essentially saved his career because he's like, this guy's so great. You want to do what he wants you to do. You want to create stuff because he's so exciting. He's given new life to Andy Reid.
All right, I got it.